there is one event early in the history of Livermore. You know, the arguments that led to the establishment of Livermore took a little longer than what I seem to have described here. We did not get going until the summer of 1952. And not much later, the first plans on a real hydrogen bomb were to be tested. The details had been actually worked out by Johnny Wheeler's group, not in Los Alamos, but back in a small temporary group in Princeton. An excellent piece of work. The test was to occur in the Pacific. I was kindly invited to attend, but Livermore was just getting going. I did not feel I could leave for even a couple of weeks. It is one of my memories that I like to tell about. I could not be at the test, but one of my very excellent friends, Dave Griggs, a man who knew everything about earthquakes, made calculations. The planned big explosion above ground would push the surface down, would generate a relatively mild earthquake wave. However, with any decent apparatus, this mild wave could be sensed around the world. So I, not being able to go to the Pacific, went to the seismograph in Berkeley. At the right time, I sat before it and watched a little green spot. If there was an earthquake wave, that spot would dance, would move. But somehow things did not work.